I started out as an evolutionary biologist and a behaviorist. What got me into working on climate change was really a fluke of luck. So NASA put out a research funding program announcement for people to work on climate change. And at the very bottom, they had one little sentence of this whole page describing what they wanted to fund that said, "And we're interested in responses of species." And I thought, I've been working for 10 years on this butterfly, the single species, Aedes checkspot butterfly, that everyone knows is incredibly sensitive to climate. This was in the early 1990s, so this is when climate scientists were still, they expected the increase in greenhouse gases to be driving warming, but they still weren't sure they were actually seeing a significant warming trend in the globe. And I thought, ha, my little butterfly will be, if anything is going to be an indicator of climate change, it's going to be this little butterfly. What happened is at the end of 4 years of field work, I'm looking at all the data, and it's of course, you know, about 40% of the populations were extinct, even though the habitat was gorgeous and there's lots of host plant and lots of nectar. And that's what I expected, but I started looking at that pattern and I thought, wow, the rate of extinction is really high in the south and it's really low in the north up in Canada. And you know, it's really low at the highest elevations. I was expecting something very sophisticated having to do with different ecotypes of the butterfly. And I thought, this is really simple. It's just shifting its range northward and upward. My goodness. You know, and this has only been with 0.6 degrees centigrade of warming in that region. It couldn't have been simpler. I couldn't have made up the data and had it be a simpler, more clear result. So I got it published in Nature, and boom, as a single author paper, and boom, I was a climate change biologist. I was very careful about how I chose the populations to look at, and how I defined the habitat still being suitable. I was very, very rigorous. If it wasn't absolutely, obviously fantastic habitat, I didn't include the population. And when it came out, I was very proud that Rush Limbaugh talked about it on his talk show, and the only thing he could say about it was, well, you know, this little gal from Texas is looking at climate change, and you know what, she's found this butterfly's moving north. We don't have to worry about climate change. Everything's just gonna move a little bit further north. Ain't that wonderful? And I thought, if that's the worst thing he can think of to say about my study, I did it right.